Hey everyone, in this video we will discuss a math lumpiad problem. The question is taken from American Junior High School Math Exam AJHSME 1987. Now this is an easy question but quite interesting one. So we have three numbers 9876 A3 to B1 and we are given that A and B are non-zero digits. Then we have to find the number of digits in sum. We don't have to find the sum because we don't know the digits. But we have to find the number of digits in this. So we have 9876 A3 2 and B1. Now here you can do a mistake. B1 is written here, but can I leave this place empty? No, you can't add like that, right? So let's say I write B1 here, then what does this place mean? Then I will have to add some digit like 0 or something, but I can't add, right? B1 is not same as B10. So it means that even if it is written like that, you can't add this way. You have to put B1 here. So you have to put B1 here, not here. This is wrong, okay? Because this place will be empty for you. Now how can I add them? Because I don't know these digits, so I will have to try one by one. Now notice one thing, I don't have to worry about the sum. I have to worry about only the number of digits in this sum. So let us take two extreme cases. And then we will see if those two have different digits or not. Let's say I find that both these two extreme cases have same digits, same number of digits. Then there is no need to worry because if I choose any intermediate case, then again my number of digits is going to remain same. So what I'm saying is these two extreme cases would be, let us take the smallest possible digit. So A equal to B equal to 1. This could be the smallest possible. And the largest would be A equal to B equal to 9. Now we have to solve these two cases. 9876 and A32. I am trying the smaller one. And B1. Now if you add them, then you are going to get 9, 11, 1, sorry, that this would be 0, 0, 1. So we got 1, 0, 0, 1, 9 and number of digits is 5, number of digits equal to 5. This was my smallest possible one. Now let us try for largest, second extrema case. So 9876, we have A32B1. So this would be 93291. So here I choose 1 and here I am choosing 99. Now let us add these. So 6 to 8, 6 to 1, 9, 7 3 10 9 19 1 9 18 1 10 0. So 10899. Now again the same number of digits. Number of digits is still 5 only. So what does this indicate? This indicate that if I choose any other digit in between 1 to 9, let's say I choose A equal to 5, B equal to 7. Even in that case, I'm not going to get more than 5 digits. Because I found that even if I was choosing a smaller digit than this, then again, still I was getting 5 digits. And if I'm choosing larger than these two possible digits, 9, 9, then still I'm going to get 5 digits. It means that irrespective of what I'm going to choose, whatever digit I am going to choose, my number of digits is still going to remain same and the number of digits is 5. So this is my answer. So this is always going to be 5. It is independent of what digit I am going to choose for A and B. So I hope this is clear. This question seems to be an easy one at first glance, but it might trouble you. Okay. And two things you have to worry. The very first thing is that you can't add b, even if it b1 is placed here, you can't add like that, right? You have to place b1 at its right position, so you will have to shift it by one place. So let's meet in some other videos. We will discuss some more such questions. Also, if you like our content, then you can always subscribe to our channel and share it with other people who are interested in math. So thank you.